Hi, my name is Phuong, and in this video, I'll be telling you guys a story. The story begins with John, the guy wearing blue shirt here. John is the chief finance officer of a multi-million dollar water treatment plant. He oversees the operational costs of the company. In recent years, John noticed that there's one big chunk of cost, but takes up about 10% of the total cost every year. And that's the cost of fixing and replacing the water pipeline. Each year, these costs seem to be increasing. It looks like the pipeline needs fixing and replacing more often than previously. John is very curious for an explanation for this uprising cost, so he went and asked Ben, who works as an engineer. Ben, can you tell me what's going on with the pipeline? It's eating up my budget. Ben explained to John that the pipelines are constantly under the attack of water and air. These two enemies will rust any steel structure. Then over some time, the pipeline will need fixing and eventually a replacement when it can't be fixed anymore. However, Ben also noticed that the pipeline is failing at a much faster rate than what he could predict. Things just do not end up here. Something else besides water and air is accelerating the whole corrosion process and caused premature destruction of the pipeline, probably 20 years earlier than its supposed lifespan. Now, this is where I come into the story, because Ben forgot about the third enemy to any steel structure in general, and that is bacteria. Yes, bacteria can attach themselves on steel and form this thick, sticky matrix that takes away metal. It is estimated that bacteria are eating away Australian industry from $30 to $35 billion a year. I study how bacteria accelerate corrosion on steel, and I do so by exposing the bacteria to steel. Then I use advanced DNA technology to wash them inside out. So how exactly do I do that? When there is a change in the environment, such as the addition of steel, bacteria start sending out these messenger signals that can be collected and used to trace back what physiological changes are happening inside them. By tracking all of these changes, I will understand how did the bacteria acquire steel, how do they process this, and what did they use steel for? Once I know the answer to why and how the bacteria are eating up steel, inhibitors can be specifically designed to target this process and stop their influence. With my study, Ben can extend the lifetime of his pipeline, John will be happy on saving some extra cash, last but not least, my study will be saving Australian industry at least $30 billion a year. Thank you for listening.